You're watching UNICEF television. 12-year-old Bana Lafia can do something her parents cannot: read. Illiteracy is a serious problem in Benin. Nearly two-thirds of the adult population is illiterate. Unable to read or write a simple statement in everyday life, Bana's parents have not been able to play any role in her education, until now.
We now understand what's happening with Bana at school because the form helps us to understand whether she's done well or not. This helps us to follow up with her progress.
This monitoring sheet has empowered Bana's parents to be active participants in her schooling. In the rural town of Sinende, parents have been trained with these visual cards to help them keep track of their child's progress. Students bring the cards home every month to update their parents on their academic status. Red means the student is performing below average, yellow indicates average, and green means the child is doing well. Other indicators, such as attendance and behavior, are also noted on these sheets in order to provide a complete picture of their child's progress.
La situation de l'éducation, d'une façon générale, au Bénin.
Before this UNICEF-supported program, Benin's education system was in a poor state. Low access to schooling for children and other issues contributed to the system's dire state. First, the enrollment rate of children into schools was very low. Second, the rate of children completing primary school was also low. And thirdly, there was a large gender gap. Many more boys than girls were being sent to school.
This innovative and cost-effective initiative, created by UNICEF in cooperation with Benin's Ministry of Education, has incentivized Bana to perform to the best of her ability and is giving her a chance to graduate to secondary school. Currently, less than one quarter of Benin's teenagers are enrolled in high school.
I would be upset if I couldn't go to school because I now know that not going to school, I won't be able to achieve my goals.
But Bana's hard work has paid off so far. She's also been chosen to participate in another UNICEF initiative, a girl-to-girl mentoring program where she tutors younger students vulnerable to dropping out of primary school.
I'm pleased to be a mentor, because if the mentee I'm helping doesn't work hard, I can help her to get better.
Currently, the educational gender gap is under 10%, which is significant progress. We know that the final 10% will be hard to close. So the government, with partners, is now focusing on the schooling of all children. The major focus is still on girls, but also on all vulnerable children.
While adolescence can be an extremely vulnerable time, it can be an age of opportunity for girls like Bana.
We want her to stay in school as long as possible and become a productive person and not be blind and deaf as we are.
Through programs like these, extraordinary advances have been achieved so that girls and vulnerable children have a better chance of finishing elementary school. Indicators now show Benin could achieve Universal Primary Education, Millennium Development Goal 2, by 2015. The monitoring sheet tool has been so successful that the initiative has been adopted nationwide. UNICEF remains committed to adolescents, especially during this tenuous time, to guide them along a path to self-sufficiency and support their vision for the future of their communities. This is Vivian Siu reporting for UNICEF Television. For more information, go to unicef.org. Unite for Children.